right. Hello, everyone. Welcome to the Lawrence at Home. My name is Fira, and I'm one of the educators from the Lawrence Hall of Science. And welcome to today's story time. So first of all, I just want to say thank you so much for all your support. Our series, Black Voices in STEAM, was received very well. So we wanted to turn it into a series within story time. And the series is now called Stories in STEAM, where we tell stories of scientists and highlight and acknowledge their achievements and accomplishments. So our story time today will be the first episode in the Stories in STEAM series. So before we get into it, please like this video and subscribe to the Lawrence at Home channel to show your support. And let's get into the story right away. All right, so for our first story in the Stories of STEAM today, I'm gonna read you the story of David Blackwell, the genius statistician. So who exactly is David Blackwell? Let's get right into it. So David Harold Blackwell is an American mathematician and statistician. He made significant contributions to branches of applied mathematics, such as game theory, probability theory, information theory, and Bayesian statistics. Wow, that is a lot of topics and field. And I think from this, we can see that Blackwell is really capable in his field, and he's really an expert in what he did. Blackwell is also a pioneer in textbook writing. So Blackwell was born in April 24, 1919 in Centralia, Illinois. In elementary school, his teachers promoted him beyond his grade level twice. So this means that Blackwell was able to climb up the grade level before his classmates did. And for him, for his teacher to be able to promote him to a higher grade, that means that Blackwell must be really smart. He must be doing really well in class. And his passion for math began in his high school geometry course. So very similar to some other scientists that we've read about, their love and their passion for the field that they end up doing, we can already see that from when they were such a young age. So then Blackwell graduated high school and enrolled in the University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign, or UIUC, when he was only 16 years old. And that's a pretty young age to graduate from high school and enter university. So afterwards, Blackwell also obtained his master's and his PhD in UIUC before taking part in postdoctoral fellowship in the Institute of Advanced Study, or IAS, in Princeton, New Jersey. So this meant that Blackwell was doing research with the Institute of Advanced Study. And the Institute of Advanced Study is really close to Princeton University because they were both in New Jersey. And historically, IAS has collaborated with the nearby Princeton University for research. So even though the Institute of Advanced Study is not officially part of Princeton, they often collaborated, and the members of IAS usually are allowed to use the facilities that are in Princeton University. However, Blackwell was prevented from doing any of these. He was not able to attend lectures or undertake any research in Princeton University due to his race. If you think back about the scientists that we've talked about in Black Voices in STEAM, you can see that this is sort of a common pattern. For the longest time, Black people have to endure this sort of discrimination. And unfortunately, it still happens today. And that really saddens me, but what do you think? Why don't you think about it or discuss it with someone while we move on with the story? So because he was treated this way, Blackwell was not able to do his research as well as possible in IAS. So he decided in the end that he would leave IAS, and then he was looking for a permanent position. In 1944, he was offered a job in Howard University, and he was appointed full professor and head of the mathematics department within 3 years. And while he was working in Howard University, he worked in the RAND, or RAND Corporations, in the summer. And when he was working here, he and other mathematicians explored the theory of duals and applied game theory. So I've mentioned this before. I talked about game theory when I introduced Blackwell, And I hope you agree with me that this sounds really, really interesting. Game theory, theory of games, what is it? So let's dive a little bit into what exactly is game theory, like what is it that Blackwell was studying? So game theory is the science of strategy, or at least it is the optimal decision-making between competing individuals in a strategic setting. That sounds really confusing, but pretty much game theory is the theory that studies how people make decisions. So for example, if there are two or more people in a situation where there's a winner and a loser, so like in a game, you know, someone wins and someone loses, this theory studies how people will make decisions or the strategies that they will take so that they can get the best results or the best outcomes. So that is game theory. And Blackwell applied this theory to military situations, where he analyzed the optimal timing of theoretical armed duelists. And it was very important for him to study this because then we can use the strategy and apply it to real life situations. And other than game theory, Blackwell also gave other significant contributions to mathematical statistics. He was known for his independent development of dynamic programming. And we can really tell his importance from the theorems that bear his name, such as the Blackwell Renewal Theorem that's used in engineering and the Rayo-Blackwell Theorem that's used in statistics. So we've seen how Blackwell has done a lot of contributions to his field. And previously, Blackwell is only limited to historically Black colleges. But that changed in the 1950s, where Blackwell landed a job in UC Berkeley. So David Blackwell was the first Black tenured faculty member at UC Berkeley. He was a professor and the chair of the statistics department in 1955. So Blackwell is actually our very own icon. He is an icon of UC Berkeley. And in 2018, UC Berkeley named an undergraduate residence hall in his honor. And this is the David Blackwell Hall that opened in fall 2018. So if you live in Berkeley, like some of us in the Lawrence at home, you might have seen this building when you go past Durant or Dana. And every time I walk past that building, I'm reminded of Blackwell and all of his achievements. And hopefully after listening to the story, you will too. So Blackwell have made many important moments in history. He was the 7th African-American to receive a PhD in mathematics. And he was also the first African-American ever to be inducted to the National Academy of Sciences. So these are really amazing achievements and milestones because he was able to be the first at something. And that means that he was able to break all those barriers and be able to do what he originally couldn't do. And I think that's really, really amazing. And by the time he retired, Blackwell has published over 90 books and papers in dynamic programming, game theory, and mathematical statistics. Blackwell also received many honors and awards for his contribution to math and statistics. And with that, we've reached the end of our story time today. I hope you enjoyed our story time today, enjoyed the first episode of Stories in STEAM. And yeah, I hope you had fun learning about David Blackwell and learning a little bit about game theory as well, because I included some of that in there. And yeah, thank you so much for watching. Please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel to show your support. And yeah, I will see you in our next story time. Bye, everyone.